Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I will find out starting in today's game between the Texas San Antonio Roadrunners and the USC Trojans.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Trojans are the highly favored team in this one, Dick. Still, what are the keys for the game?
Well, the keys should be simple tonight, Brad. First of all, the point guard has to be the coach on the floor, making sure his team executes on every possession. Second of all, get the ball to your big man on the block early. That'll open up the perimeter game, baby. And finally, make good passes and force the other team to play honest defense.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. There they come with a double team to stop it. Barry fakes the shot. They work the perimeter. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
The point guard with the ball. Both teams looking to get things going here. Looking to move it around the perimeter. From three-point territory. Questionable shot selection there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. Trying to go inside.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards are there.
Yeah, that helps. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Nick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. On the inside, looking for contact. Keeps the dribble as they regroup.
This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
And he missed. Ricks is feeling great right now.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Executes the baby hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
They look to get it to the inside. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot. Let's get another look, Brad. Hey, this crowd will be ecstatic if they can get a basket.
The center gets the ball and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot. Great shot block right there. Had some good movement on the offensive side.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
He pump fakes. Tries for two. Doesn't go. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Thanks, Aaron. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important.
Blocks the shot. The point guard gets the pass. Trying to feed inside. And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from the top of the key. Got it. Dumps it in. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play. Let's see if they go two for one here, Brad.
Jump hook from the low block.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Up fake. He attempts a jump hook. Can't get the shot to go. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He uses the shot fake. He fakes the shot. Now the turnaround jumper. They still don't score. Can't put it down. At the half, the Roadrunners are trailing by two. Best play of that half. Let's take another look. USC did a masterful job of grabbing the boards in the first half, Mr. Vitale.
Wow, I'll tell you, Brad, these guys are so well coached. The coaching staff preaches the importance of winning the rebound battle. And then they went out there and they just did that.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. Thinks about the shot. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player. Here's one for the highlight reel.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job.
Ooh, look at the shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
The shot. Shot goes up and in.
Hey, there's just too much space.
Here's a spin down in the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, now the spin move to the goal.
Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making the quarter lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Buries it home.
He's a high riser. Sensational, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. The ball handler might be in trouble here. He takes it away. For the bucket. Drops the bucket despite the harm. He intercepts it. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
He does the sweet fake shot. He's got a nice shot fake for the bucket.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Nick.
Well, you got to think the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Steals the pass. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. On the outside.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And now they'll bring it up. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries for two. Finger roll. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
Foster is pretty fired up and excited.
He may be in his zone right now, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. Stolen ball.
Look at that spacing.
He launches the bomb.
Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go. You need to create as many possessions as possible, so keep falling.
Now it's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And yet another foul. Stop with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
He goes to the line for the first time. Misses the front end of the one and one.
They need to score here to turn this into a one possession game.
Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Erin Andrews.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, thanks, Erin. Play about ready to resume. It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
Buckles handles the pass. He goes for the trifecta. He cleans the glass. Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Makes the second.
This is important possession if they want a chance to win.
It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. Puts it up. He's taking too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
They're working around the perimeter. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on, one team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, they did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
USC played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.